Welcome to a video of basic electricity. Electricity is a great gift of science given to the world. It has become a part of our modern lifestyle. We cannot imagine our daily lives without this wonderful gift. Electricity is all around us, powering houses, offices, and technologies like our computer, light, mobile, etc. It gives all the comfort and provides almost all entertainment devices. Now let us go through some basics of electricity. Let us discuss about electric charges. An atom has three particles, electron, proton, and neutron. A negatively charged particle is called an electron, while a positive charge is called as proton. Electricity is the flow of charges. To make these charges flow, there should be some force called as electrostatic force. The force that acts between the electron and the proton is called as electrostatic force. From the figure, we can see like charges repel each other while the unlike charges attract each other. Let us understand about the conductor and insulator. A conductor is a substance that allows electricity to pass through it. This helps in the electron flow, so these are used to prepare wires. Example, copper, gold, silver, etc. While insulators are elements which do not help in electron flow as well as do not help in flow of electricity. So it is used to make the outer covering of the wire and many other safety materials. Example, wood, glass, plastic, etc. What is electric field? The region around the electric charge in which the electric force acts is called as an electric field. If the magnitude of the charge is very large, then it may create a huge force around the region. We can represent the electric field by the symbol E. So E is equal to F by Q, where F is the force and Q will be the charge. The SI unit of the electric field is Newton per Coulomb, which is equal to volt per meter. Let's go through the generation of electricity. Electricity is generated from different sources like sun, wind, heat, nuclear elements, and many others. The various methods of generating electricity are thermal plants. A power station in which the heat energy is converted to electric power is called as thermal power station. Nuclear plants. Another type of thermal power plant is the nuclear plant. Here the heating source is the nuclear reactor. Other renewable sources. Natural elements like sun, water, wind, etc. also generate electricity. Example, solar panels, windmill, etc. What is the electric current? We can say it is the core of electricity. Electric current is the motion of the charged particles in the wire, or we can say that the continuous flow of electrons in an electric circuit. The conducting material consists of large number of free electrons that move from one atom to another freely. Electric current is denoted by the symbol I. I is equal to Q by T, where Q is the charge and T is the time. The unit of charge is coulomb and the time in seconds. So, the unit of I is ampere. So, we can say that 1 ampere of electric current means 1 coulomb of charge passing through a conductor in 1 second. Now, let us learn about the direction of electric current. From the figure, when we connect the battery to a conductor, the electrons start moving from the negative terminal of the battery to the positive terminal of the battery, while the direction of the conventional current is from the positive terminal of the battery to the negative terminal. Based on the flow of electrons, the current is mainly classified into two types, alternating current and direct current. In alternating current, the flow of charges changes its direction periodically. This type is used for power buildings, offices, etc. The main socket at our home provides the AC supply. In direct current, the flow of charges occurs only in one direction. In a DC source, electrons move from negative terminal to the positive terminal of the battery. This is used for most of the low power devices. The main two effects of electric current are heat effect and magnetic effect. In heat effect, current is dissipated in the form of heat. If the current flowing is less, then the heat will be less. And if the current flowing is more, then the heat flow will be more. So we can say that the heat dissipated is directly proportional to the current flowing. This heating effect is used in many ways. It is also used in electric fuse, in which the fuse wire breaks, which in turn breaks the circuit when the heat is more. Other examples are electric kettle, electric room heater, etc. In magnetic effect, a magnetic field can be observed across a current-carrying wire. We can observe a deflection if we place a compass near an electrically stressed conductor. This shows the presence of a magnetic field, for example, electric bell, TV, radio, telephone, etc. Now let us learn about electrical safety. Safety is the main concern while working with electricity. We should always be cautious as there is a possibility of an electric shock or burn. When a voltage is applied across two points of a body, a current path is provided and the current produces an electric shock. The electronic components are usually operated at high temperatures, and so when we come in contact with them, we can suffer skin burns. Now, what is electric shock? An electric shock happens when an electric current passes through our body. Both internal and external tissue can burn and cause organ damage also. When a point on our body comes in contact with voltage and another point comes in contact with a different voltage or ground, then there will be a current through our body from one point to another. The severity of the electric shock depends on the amount of the voltage and the path that the current takes through our body. Now let us consider the effects of electric current on the human body. The nervous system experiences an electric shock when an electric current passes through the body. The intensity of the shock mainly depends on the strength of the current, the duration of the contact, and the path taken by the current through the body. In extreme cases, the shock causes the failure of the normal action of heart and lungs, even death. This is a graph showing the physical effort for various values of current in milliamperes. For low values, there will be a slight sensation effects only, but as the value increases, the risk factor also increases and it may even cause to death. Thank you for watching the video. For more details, please visit our website or mail to us.